Hi everyone and welcome to STEM Club India webcast conversation with top educators. Today we have Mr. Yathart Gautam, Director and CEO Birla Open Minds. How are you, sir?
Very good, Yashan. How are you?
Good, doing good. Thanks for asking. Mr. Yathart Gautam completed his graduation in BA Honours International Business from Regent Business School London and MBA International Marketing from EU Business School Barcelona. Worked for top global MNCs industries catering to steel and services at senior positions. A firm believer in a motto of dictum meum pactum, he adheres to what to the principle of performing what he say he will do. Currently associated with Birla Open Minds, serving as director and CEO, we are blessed to have him today to take his inputs. We'll start our interview with a small question, sir. How is the journey so far?
That's a good question. It's been very interesting, actually. The journey has been, very smooth. And despite COVID, it's been smooth. Everything has been on the upswing and learning throughout the period. I think that's what we really enjoy, and I personally really enjoy it. So the more challenges, the more solutions, the more happiness.
What was that moment where decided that you become educational? Because I can see you are a thorough, I'll say, a businessman or someone who was there with the corporate. So what was that moment which made you realize that you should be moving towards the education fraternity?
What made me realize I want to get into education? So basically, I was working in different industries earlier. I was in the steel sector. When I came back to India, and when I did my MBA and my undergrad abroad, I realized that the education, the way it's imparted over there, is very, very different from what we're doing in India right now. And I remember my time as a student, it was a lot of rote learning, and I've been all around India because my dad had worked in a transferable job. So I studied in CBSE schools, I studied in ICSE schools. We didn't have IB and all of that at that point. And I was not a bright student. I'm very honest. I was not a bright student. I was probably the first guy to get told to leave the classroom. But when I went abroad, I realized that I was doing well. And I realized that I think it's the way they're teaching me, and it's sort of connecting with me. I can understand what they're saying better, I can visualize it better, and I can obviously write it down better when it comes down. So when I came back, I came across this opportunity, and I was like, why not get into this and actually try and make it easy for the students over here.
Do you have any ideal or any celebrity you follow?
I don't know if you've heard of a gentleman called Mark Rich. He is someone I do idolize. He was a very massive oil trader in his time. And the reason I idolize him is just, his principles, his lifestyle, the way he approaches work and passion for work, for anything that he does, is something I really look up to.
Okay, perfect. And any mantra or quote you follow? I've already read in your introduction, but just want to know more about it.
Well, it's very simple. Dictum meum pactum. I mean, you meet a lot of people every day. Everyone tells you that, yeah, main ye karunga, or I'll do this. So when it comes to work and even in general social commitments, if I've given a commitment to someone, I can ensure that it is done. I don't like to leave openings. I really hate leaving open loops. My inbox has zero emails by Friday. So,
okay. Any favorite sport? Because as a company, we are a firm believer of sports fitness, and we are now working in STEM also. So just want to know what sports you follow during your school days.
School days, I was heavily into lawn tennis and cricket.
Okay. All right. And still pursuing it?
I don't get the time. But I do play on and off whenever I can, and with the kids. And I've got two young daughters, so I can.
Makes sense. And any hobbies you currently you pursue and you have?
I've always been heavily into music. For me, music is something, any genre. I'm not very particular about genres. It's quite soothing. For me, that's my stress buster.
Okay. All right. So this was section one, more about to know you. We'll move to our next section, which is around STEM, because as we mentioned, we are in STEM and we want to know your inputs and thoughts so that not only us, there are many other companies also, they can improvise and they can come up with better solutions. So starting with my very first question is that how STEM education is changing life of your students?
See, I think STEM has changed lives leaps and bounds. Like, I just gave you an example during my school time. You know, we didn't. Today, I can see children in our schools in Birla Open Mind and other schools as well that they can actually visualize and see, you know, particles moving or vibrating. And these things were not there, and you know, in our time. And I think these kind of, it makes it easy for the learner to actually understand what is being told to them and to grasp it more easily. The more they grasp and the easily, with the ease that they can grasp it, is I think STEM is being very, very usual.
Okay. And so do you think current STEM initiatives in India are giving justice in preparing next generation youth?
I think a lot more can be done.
Mm-hmm.
I think they're doing well, but there is still, I would say, the lack of knowledge at some parts where how it can actually be utilized to the right amount. Because we have schools in tier 2, tier 3, tier 4 cities. So when I speak to those owners, they don't really understand the importance of STEM. So that's where we come in, and it's our job to obviously tell them that this is a brilliant platform. Use it and trust me, you will get it.
There are many students who will be listening to this. Your message to students. What do you want to give a message?
Don't take stress. Don't worry about things. I'm a guy who scored zero on tests. I'm someone who's been thrown out of classes. But at the same time, I've been responsible enough to do something with my life. And I don't think anything is impossible. So don't take stress. I hear a lot, and it really affects me because the way kids are taking anxiety levels today and all of that. I don't think that's the right approach. Be stress-free, smile, laugh. Life's a beautiful journey, so you should live through each moment with a smile.
Perfect message. Don't take stress, smile, and enjoy your journey. Yeah, that makes sense. And your message to young educators?
I think don't give up. I know it's difficult when the educators are approaching companies and, you know, pitching their products, and there are a lot of them in the market. So please understand it's difficult for us also, because you guys are so leaps and bounds ahead of us that we sometimes get confused here. What's the USP here? What's the USP? You know, so don't give up. I think keep innovating. That's the brilliant thing that we can do. And sure that India can transform if we just move at the same pace.
Okay. All right. So tell us about school achievements. Anything which you want to highlight?
So we have this, we have a holistic approach in our schools. We call it a 360 degree approach for the child. That takes care of what I was touching on earlier about anxiety levels and stress and all.
Yeah.
So that's something that we are personally very proud of. Our chairman is very actively involved in all of these things. He doesn't like it when we hear or read articles which are, you know, bad for, and especially if it involves children. So what we do in our schools is we have a whole subject which we've curated called Soul Science. It's not a subject like how we have in our times, like, you know, social studies, not social studies, but like literature or something like that, where, you know, it's just our attendance, and, you know, that's it. It teaches you to calm down, it teaches you the importance of meditation, importance of relaxation. So that's really helped a lot of students, and we do get a lot of letters from students saying that, you know, this is really helping. Our parents appreciate it. Everyone is so busy nowadays in their lives that parents spend a little less time with kids. So that's something that we're proud of in our country.
No, this is phenomenal. You're taking stress out of student, giving them a holistic approach to understand and giving them different kind of learning opportunities. This is something phenomenal. I'm pretty sure students are blessed to be there in Birla Open Minds. So kudos to you and your team. Moving to our next section, it is more like a rapid fire. I'll start with the very first question, which is like your favorite subject.
English.
Okay. The subject you don't like?
Chemistry.
Okay. Favorite sport now?
Football.
Favorite Sudhin?
Indian.
Okay. Your dream vacation?
Iceland. Although I've been there, but I would love, I go there every time. Every time we just go
there. All right. Iceland. Okay. All right. Your, any favorite book you have?
Currently, King of Voice, Mark Rich.
All right. You have already told us regarding your music fantasy. Anything you want to share regarding that also?
Regarding music, listen to it whenever you can.
As you mentioned, there are many programs happening around. We just want to have your preference. What do you think about them? So, preference in terms of artificial intelligence, drone, FNN schools, robotics, coding. What do you think as per you? Is doing the best or should be at number one?
Formula One.
Okay.
Probably artificial intelligence.
Right.
What was my other option?
Then we have drones, robotics, coding.
So drone, then robotics, and at the end I'll put coding. Too much coding.
I'll put coding at the last, but just want to know your thoughts around it. Any particular reason?
I think there's no particular reason. I just think that companies are marketed in a way that people think it's the next big thing, but it is important and it's good. I'm not taking that away from coding, but I think there's much more than coding that can actually add value. Like Formula One, for example. I used to follow Formula One a lot when I was a kid. Lost touch and things, but we never had the platform. To even think about Formula One, how are you even supposed to get into it, or what are the avenues, how is it helpful? So I think coding is just a big thing.
Again, as you mentioned, that company are, I think, marketing it in a wrong way. Maybe that will improve and it will get its own, it will take its own time. But yes, definitely it is important, but it should not be done in the fashion which is done at this particular moment. If you're a student, what course you have opted out of these?
Formula One.
All right. Okay. Thanks a lot. I think so. This will give us, some confidence that, yes, people know about Formula One in school and this is doing good. So thanks a lot. The entire series is to know our educators who are basically shaping up the entire education fraternity, know their thoughts. And we'll definitely request for a round two, which will be more towards sports and fitness as a company, because we are doing that. And maybe next year, early starting, we'll be requesting for another session. Thanks a lot for coming on our webcast. Any concluding comments you have, we'll be more than happy.
Thank you for inviting me. And I think this was very fun, very different from the usual session that we do. It's good to know that Formula One in schools is getting this platform out, and like you rightly mentioned, in a very classic manner and a classy manner as opposed to in your face manner. So I'm looking forward to seeing more Formula One in all our schools. I'm actually surprised you guys haven't started in Birla Open Minds.
Yeah, thanks a lot, and your words are truly inspirational. Thanks a lot for your time. And whatever you have told us, I'm pretty sure students, educators will get most of it.